I'm going to show you what was written in scripture, what was prophesied about today. It says, but understand this. This is something you must understand. That in the last days, there will come times of difficulty. And these are difficult times, people.
Go ahead, read it.
For people will be lovers of self. How many people love yourself? How many of y'all love yourself? How many of you love yourself more than you love your neighbor? He says, what? For people will be lovers of money. How many of you love money? You love money, don't you?
Who don't love money?
He says, what? People will be proud. How many of you are proud? How many of you are arrogant, abusive, disobedient to your parents, ungrateful, unholy, heartless, unappeasable, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not loving good? And we can see that in the world. Don't nobody love what's good. Look at that. Look at the things you're teaching your children. Look at the things you're putting on TV. Nobody loves what is good. You hate what is good. Because the Bible says, what? Men love darkness more than they love light. And they won't come to the light, what? Lest their darkness be exposed and God change them. The Bible says, what? That's why Jesus always said, he who has ears to hear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying. And the Spirit is saying this, come to Christ. Turn away from your sins. Come and receive the grace and the mercy of God who loves you. And the Bible says, what? That men will be brutal. Not loving good, treacherous, reckless, swollen with conceit, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God.
This is the last day.
Having the appearance of godliness, but denying his power. And the power of God is in the cross. The power of God is in that cross, my friends, that Jesus, he bore in his body the sins of us all. When he was beaten, when he was bruised, he was beaten for you. He was beaten for all of you. Everybody walking the street, Jesus was crushed for you.
What?
Instead of God taking your life and giving you the sentence that you deserve, which is death, which is hell, God gave you the day to change your lives. He gave you the day to turn from your sexual immorality and impurity, to turn from your homosexuality and your wickedness and your sins. God's giving you today to turn, because tomorrow isn't promised.
What?
How many of you people should be grateful to the Lord today that you're in good health when there are people in the hospital suffering?
Amen.
And I pray for those people that God will have mercy on them, that he'll heal their bodies so that they can have one more chance if they don't know him. But I'm telling you, my friends, that day is coming for you. The Bible says, what? We all going to die. For what? For the wages of sin is death.
What?
And we all have sinned. Therefore, we all going to die. Could you deny it? Don't you know your day of reckoning is coming? Don't you know your day is coming, my friends? The day of your death. The day of your appointment to God. And who can stand before him? The Bible says what? It is a fearful thing to stand before the living God. It is a fearful thing to stand before the judge and the creator and maker of your souls, my friends. And a lot of people laugh and mock and scorn, but the Bible says, yeah, you do that. But you won't be laughing in the end. You're going to be pleading and begging the Lord. Lord, have mercy on me. But by then, it's too late. By then, it's too late, my friends. And I'm here to tell you, you can harden your heart, but the Bible, as the Holy Spirit says, do not harden your heart as in a rebellion. While God is giving you time, while you can hear the sound of my voice, turn from your sins and turn to Jesus Christ, because you don't know what's going to happen. You don't know. You can't see your future. You can't see it. The only reason you're alive is because of the grace and the mercy of God and his compassion upon your life. That's the only reason you're here. Because God says he does not desire for you to perish, but he desires for you to know the truth, that you may be saved, that you may be healed. Because in Christ's blood there is healing. And his healing is the healing of the soul, the healing of the mind. And God wants you to purify your mind. And I'm here to tell you, my friends, to turn to Christ today. Turn to Jesus, because he is a good and faithful God, a merciful God. And I want to share some more scriptures. This is what the Word of God says, my friends. This is how we are saved. And it's in Ephesians chapter 2, verses 8. It says what? For by grace you have been saved through faith. And it says what? And this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast. So my friends, God's grace